If you haven't had a chance to take a look at Channel Port, this is your opportunity. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Harmonic. My name is Linda. Now, launching a new channel or service can be a time-consuming, expensive, and complicated process, right? Finding the attributes for the server, the video server, branding, automation, and other infrastructures that are required, and then dealing with all the different vendors, working with lead time, installing the equipment, and finally testing and launching a new channel. So given that, imagine instead if you could simply add a single device to your existing infrastructure, a device that could provide all of the functionality that's needed for a new channel, a device that could be online and on air in a matter of hours, not days or weeks. Well, we at Harmonic are proud to introduce the latest addition to the Spectrum family at NAB this year. This is called Channel Port. And Channel Port is a new modular device that works with the Spectrum Media Server component, and it speeds the deployment of new channels. So it reduces costs by integrating clip playouts. And it has significant new capabilities, such as channel branding, live master control switching, and EAS support. Also, Channel Port fits seamlessly into existing infrastructures to simplify the launch of new services. It has rich multi-layer graphics and dynamic text that can be easily keyed over programming, while support for a broad range of automation systems offers you the freedom to choose exactly what's best for your workflow. Now, as you may know, for many years now, Spectrum has been the industry's most trusted playout platform, powering thousands of channels all around the world. Well, now, in addition to lead clip playback capabilities, Channel Port is able to, it has logos and regulatory marks, it has lower thirds now and dynamic text, scrolling dynamic text and tickers, and full screen plates. So it also has master control switching between live and clip playback, full emergency alert system support, and on-demand branded preview functionality, which I'm going to show you all of this. So finally, Channel works with your Spectrum, your media center, and your media deck. So let's take a little closer look at the features I was just talking about. So as you can see here, this is how you would create your on-air look. So broadcast graphics professionals are already intimately familiar with the Adobe Creative Suite of tools, right? And so we didn't feel that it would be beneficial for them to introduce a new tool just to create the on-air templates, right? So we designed Channel Port to accept graphic templates that are created directly in Adobe Flash Professional. It provides all of the familiar canvas and animation tools, and it accepts almost all standard graphic formats. All right, so looking at this middle screen here, you can see we have a canvas here. This is the timeline. When you're creating a template, you can choose the canvas size that matches that of your output resolution and begin to place those elements where you want them. So across the top here, this is what I did earlier. I have a channel logo, some regulatory marks. I created a dynamic text ticker and a lower third to display data from the NAB Twitter feed that's going on this year. So you can size them, you can place them where you want them, you can animate them with entry and exit effects if you'd like. You can directly preview them within Flash Professional. So here's a preview of the Twitter. Now, once you're happy with them, you can simply save them and push them over to the Spectrum file system, and they're immediately available for air. In fact, you can see the live Twitter feed right there. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, so once on Channel Port, I can use FX tool to manually load and preview each of those layers I created just to make sure I'm happy with my template. So I can independently load and unload each. I can change the order of the layers just by moving them around, dragging and dropping them. I can modify the entry speed just by using this drop-down menu, just to be sure that I'm happy with the look of it. Now, in addition to FX tool, I can also control these functions using GPIs, which enables me to control things with a hardware control panel. All right, so I'm happy with the layers I created in on-air look, so let's take a look. We'll simulate going to air, which you'll be able to see on that far left screen there. So I can also manually switch on each layer independently. So this is layer 2, just by pushing a button. I can turn on the channel logo to brand the output. So you see the Harmonic branding there. I can load the appropriate regulatory logos when a new program starts. And I can load dynamic text. So the text source is determined in the Flash template, and it could be an RSS feed, it could be a Twitter feed, it could an XML file, or even a database. And this one actually, as you can see here, we're displaying an RSS sports feed. You see there? All right, so without interrupting the channel branding, I can also switch between video sources with clip playback to live pass-through. This could be very useful for switching from a studio or external feed, or even providing regional opt-out capabilities. So I can also load lower thirds, as you can see right there, I showed you earlier. It's useful for overlaying additional information on the screen, just like we're doing with the NAB Twitter feed that you see right there. Or we have a now, next, later graphic with data that's populated directly from your schedule. And finally, I can also load a full screen slate. Now, this is for cases where there are technical problems or where channel port is used for regional or local opt-outs. All right, so as I mentioned before, channel port is compatible with all leading automation systems, and it uses industry standard control protocol for both clip playback and graphics control. So if you're walking around NAB this year, we've qualified some leading automation systems, so you can actually see here at NAB, this is channel port that's in multiple partner booths throughout the show this year. And unlike other products that are available today, channel port offers complete modularity and compatibility with existing Spectrum systems, so it can be used from a single channel deployment in a single device all the way up to scaled multi-channel server systems. So it's available in three main configurations. Don't keep it, you have to pass it around. We have a standalone half RU device that adds to existing Spectrum architecture to add branded channels. Then you can do channel port plus media deck, which is a channel port module that's integrated in a media deck 7000 chassis, and it functions as a standalone branding server. And finally, we have channel port plus media deck plus media port. And this is a channel port module that's integrated in either a media port 7000 or a media deck 7000 chassis. And it functions as a standalone branding server with media ingest capabilities. Now, each channel port module provides two distinct branded channels. Each of them have dual output and up-down cross conversion with aspect ratio conversion. Also, every single channel can play back any kind of combination of HD, SD, MPEG-2, and DV content back-to-back on a single timeline. And it has all the industry-leading Spectrum support for wrappers, audio, and ancillary data. You also get the FX tool, which allows manual control of the graphics. There's also a preview tool for real-time primary and secondary event previewing, and you get a range of Adobe Flash Professional template canvases and all the resolutions that you will ever need or require to get you on air very fast. So as consumer desire for more content is delivered to more devices and it increases, you'll be challenged to launch new branded channels and services a lot quicker, more cost-effectively, and reliably. Well, that is exactly what we do. Channel Port does that for you. It adds branded channels to the industry's most trusted playout platform. It has plug-and-play with Spectrum, Media Center, and Media Deck. And we have the best price and the best performance with the fastest channel deployment. It's also, as I showed you, it's supported by all leading automation systems. And Channel Port Push Through Flash Pro accepts any standard graphic format. It's industry-leading density and power consumption, and of course, finally, as I mentioned at the beginning, it has no impact on channel count. So of course, this was just a demo I put together. Please stay in our booth, go to one of the demo pods, take a closer look. I put together this demo for you earlier so you can see some of the layers, but you can actually try this for yourself. The demo stations are set up all along the inside of the booth, so go take a closer look, push the buttons, ask the questions that are important to you, let us answer them for you. If you have any questions, you can see myself or any of the Harmonic representatives that are all around here, ready to answer any questions that you might have for another 20 minutes. You're welcome to stay. If you stay past 6, you will have to vacuum, but that's all. So thanks everybody for coming by on behalf of myself and everybody here from Harmonic. Have a great evening. Thank you.
So,
you want me to see if we can interview her quickly and then go get the other guy, or we go get the other guy? Because he wants to be interviewed over there. He wants to be interviewed over there because he wants to show us one of the touch displays and talk about it. Not him around over there more.
What'd you say?
Can I scan you, please?
Can I card you, please?
I don't have any cards on me, but I'll take this. So I can scan you as well.
Sure.
Thank you very much.
How will I ever get your card?
I could get it from my purse. But if you want to get a hold of me, go ahead and call the office.
Do you work for Harmonica?
No, I do.
What do you do for them?
I'm the executive assistant to the worldwide sales.
I see.
Yes.
Heather, so you'll be